Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. In North America, we tend to think of reindeer once a year as semi-mythical flying creatures that pull Santa's sleigh around the world. Yet not only are reindeer real, if things had gone a little differently, we might be regularly chowing down on Blitzen burgers. That's because when the United States bought Alaska from Russia in the late 1800s, American entrepreneurs saw an opportunity to replicate Russia's long-established reindeer herding industry and started shipping domesticated reindeer over to Alaska. But it turns out that reindeer are kind of naughty. Entire herds disappeared into the vast Alaskan landscape, where they died or ran off with the area's native wild reindeer. Reindeer herders in Europe and Russia had similar problems, but with a 3,000-year head start, their experience gave them a keener sense of where their animals might wander. Something else that kept reindeer from taking off in North America was cows. Yes, cows. Despite lots of reindeer product marketing, Americans already had meat that they liked. They bought thousands of times more beef than reindeer each year. Yet the cattle industry still lobbied hard against reindeer, even getting some local laws passed that prohibited its sale entirely. Times were tough for the reindeer industry, and then the Great Depression struck. As people's incomes plummeted, so too did their interest in trying exotic reindeer meat. Many reindeer herders, unable to recoup their costs, left their animals to wander at will. And within 20 years, over 90% of these reindeer succumbed to overgrazing, predators, and the call of the wild. Today, a very small reindeer herding industry still exists in far northwest Alaska. But most of the meat is eaten locally. And new challenges, like a warming climate that can trap reindeer food under a thick layer of ice, are making it even tougher to herd the creatures. So for most of us, reindeer will probably remain relegated to Santa's sleigh. Rudolph, with his nose so bright, won't be on your plate tonight. You might not be eating reindeer this holiday season, but here's something that's easier to get your hands on, a free trial subscription to Audible. They're the leading provider of audiobooks with an unmatched selection of titles from all types of literature. One fun pick is The Physics of Christmas, From the Aerodynamics of Reindeer to the Thermodynamics of Turkey by Roger Highfield, which suggests that, scientifically speaking, Rudolph might actually be female. To find out why, download The Physics of Christmas or get another book of your choice for free by going to audible.com/MinuteEarth and signing up for a 30-day trial. Also, if you'd like to learn more about reindeer biology or the history of reindeer herding, join us and some reindeer experts right now on Reddit, which is hosting an Ask Science discussion about this video. The link is in the description. See you there!